The Raiders didn't get the win, but they did get to see Marcus Mariota make his debut when he came in relief for Derek Carr after a groin injury sidelined him. Let's talk number eight, because as he alluded to, lots of ups and downs throughout his career and this journey through the season alone, as Coach alluded to earlier in the show, out maybe 9 or 10 weeks, and then comes in and is able to, in many respects, ball out today. Marcel, can you talk a little bit about what skill sets you see coming out from a guy like number eight and Marcus Mariota?
You know, first of all, it's extremely special for us as the Raider Nation to have two starting caliber quarterbacks on our roster and not have that to worry about. Again, like we hinted to earlier, he showed extreme professionalism, being ready to go at the drop of a hat when DC unfortunately went down. But yeah, to answer your question, Costco, when you're talking about Marcus Mariota's skill set, he is a flat-out gamer when it comes down to it. We knew that when he first came in intended for the Titans, and he showed that he still has it. A guy that hasn't played football in over a year. Yeah. Are you kidding me? And he gets out on the football field and realizes, yes, this is still just football, and right, I can go out and play the game that I love like a kid Saturday morning. And he showed the Raider Nation that he can play football, and he loves this game. The way that he played today shows his passion and love for the game of football, and that's what we all love to see.
And fans still thought, you know, with him coming in, they weren't sure. Right. And he still very much kept the Raiders in the game, EA.
Without a doubt.
When you look at a playmaker like Marcus Mariota, how challenging of a defense is that to have to guard against?
Yeah, like, when he's playing at the top of his game like he was playing tonight, you think about the phases that he brings to the field. His accuracy on point, right? So defensively, that kind of gives you issues. You got to be sticky on your coverage. And then his ability to be able to get out, move the pocket, and make those critical plays from outside the pocket. So that puts me in a situation where I have to kind of plaster my guy and find someone in zone. And then the coach is aiding it with calling run specific plays for him. So now he's putting the ball in the belly of Josh. Mm-hmm. Josh is getting up in the middle, he pulls it, and now he's on the corner. So now if I'm a defensive end or a defensive lineman, I don't know, should I crash down on Josh? Because all week we've been talking about stop the run. And now this guy's on the edge and he's outrunning me. So he's bringing all phases of quarterbacking to this football field. And that's what you really love about him. He was extremely, extremely successful at the University of Oregon. I mean, whatever he wanted to do, he was basically able to do that. Had some hiccups in his beginning of his career, and I thought that threw him for a loop a little bit. He wasn't able just to come out and just physically dominate. Hmm. Really worked with his nerves, worked with his passion to play football. So I'm so excited that this young man has been able to recapture that tonight, and we saw him. All the facets were there, running, throwing, leadership-wise. Just unfortunate he wasn't able to bring the Raiders a win tonight, but we're in really good hands if he has to continue to quarterback for the next week or so.
Absolutely.
Really provided a spark, and even when he had that interception, he still made that huge tackle.
Great tackle.
Right?
I mean, just a great
tackle. I mean, he had the speed and the ability to make that huge tackle, which may have been a touchdown with any
other
quarterback.
Another phase he brings, tackling.
Tackling,
at the
exactly.
quarterback position.
Hopefully not.